The next symptom set of schizophrenia is hallucinations, which are disturbances of perception. When a person experiences hallucinations, they are having a false sensory experience. They believe that they are experiencing something through one of the five senses, when in fact they are not. Hallucinations, like delusions, are typically very distressing for the people who experience them, because the experience, whether it involves hearing, seeing, or feeling something that is not really there, feels every bit as real as if it was actually happening. For people with schizophrenia, by far the most common sensory modality in which hallucinations are experienced is the auditory sense, auditory referring to what we hear. The most common type of auditory hallucination that people with schizophrenia experience is hearing voices. Typically, when a person is experiencing auditory hallucinations and hearing voices, the voices are very derogatory and negative about the person in question. A person may hear one or more voices, but generally they're saying awful, mean things to the person. For example, he's worthless, he's useless. It's very unusual for the voices to say anything positive about the person experiencing them. In many years of working as a clinical psychologist, I've actually only ever met one person who experienced voices that were benign or that said nice things to her. Sometimes, when a person says they are hearing voices, they are actually talking about their own thoughts or internal monologue. The key difference between thoughts and an auditory hallucination in the form of a voice is whether the individual feels that the words being spoken are coming from inside or outside of their own mind. Generally speaking, people are able to be quite clear on this issue. If the words or voices are coming from inside your mind, we're usually talking about a thought or self-talk. Whereas if the words or voices are coming externally, as though someone else is talking to you, we're usually talking about an auditory hallucination. Although auditory hallucinations are the most common form of hallucinations, these false sensory experiences can occur in any of the other senses. Visual hallucinations refer to the experience of seeing something that is not actually there. Importantly, if a client tells you that they are experiencing visual hallucinations, you need to keep in mind that visual hallucinations are quite commonly a product of organic brain disease. Actually, this possibility of an organic cause needs to be kept in mind for any type of hallucination, but it is particularly common when we're talking about visual hallucinations. So, the possibility of an organic cause needs to be ruled out very early on. Even if other aspects of the person's presentation are consistent with a psychotic illness, we need to exclude organic causes by referring the client for an MRI or whatever other investigation is appropriate. It is, of course, possible for somebody with schizophrenia to experience visual hallucinations, but you do need to exclude organic causes first before attributing it to schizophrenia. Olfactory hallucinations involve the sense of smell. So this is where someone has the experience of smelling something that in fact is not there. One example that stands out for me over the years is a 27-year-old woman who had a very distressing olfactory hallucination, whereby she would quite frequently experience the smell of burning human flesh. Gustatory hallucinations involve the sense of taste. So when a person experiences a gustatory hallucination, they have the experience of tasting something that they are not actually tasting. A common example is the experience that the food you are eating tastes rotten when it tastes fine to others who are eating the same food. Finally, a tactile hallucination refers to a false sensory experience in relation to the sense of touch. When a person has a tactile hallucination, there is a sense of physical contact with a stimulus that is not real. One of the most common tactile hallucinations is the experience of something crawling on or under your skin, for example, maggots or cockroaches.